So this is how the tube for bronchoscopy looks like. As I told you in the exercise, the distal end is fenestrated, so when you assemble it with the other part with the handle, there is an outlet with which you plug to the respiratory system, and in this way you can observe through the bronchoscope and also to let the gases pass through and give anesthesia for the patient. It's very important to be fenestrated here. So, for example, pause.
Go.
So this is how the forceps for the bronchoscopy and esophagoscopy looks like. It's got a long arm and very small branches with which we grab the foreign body, and we can pick it out like that. And the difference now, if we are doing bronchoscopy, we go with the forceps inside the bronchoscope. For example, if this is the foreign body, we take it and we get it out from the bronchi and to extract the foreign body. While if we are with the esophagoscope, this is esophagoscopic tube, there is no fenestration at the end, at the distal. When you grab the foreign body, you grab it, if it's like that, you grab the foreign body and you got it. This is just a moment.
It's of mud, yeah.
If this is the foreign body in the esophagoscopy, you grab the foreign body and pass it through the esophagoscope in order to avoid injury of the walls of the esophagus. Okay, this is how we proceed with the manipulations. Another tool that we use for esophagoscope, these are called bougies. With these bougies we do dilatation of the esophagoscope when there is a burning injury of the esophagoscope. There are different sizes. The sizes are according to the system of Scherer. So, for example, this is the smallest size. We make esophagoscopy and put through the tube the esophagoscope, the bouche, then pull out the esophagoscope. It stays in the esophagus 5 to 10 minutes. Then we draw it out, then put the next size, which is a little bit more wider. Put it again in the esophagus, draw out the tube. Wait for 5 to 10 minutes and we proceed with this procedure till we get maximum dilatation of the esophagus. We have to be very careful not to tear the walls of the esophagus and causing mediastinitis. Okay, this is